So it looks like Microsoft might have partnered up with a studio that's been making exclusive content for the PlayStation, and I want to talk about it. But before we get on to the video, definitely hit that like button if you guys enjoy the video. You can always subscribe to the channel for weekly content, and don't forget to go over there and follow me at Twitter at LordAddictILP. Without any further ado, let's talk about this studio. Sony has been well known to making extremely high quality games all the way from God of War to Horizon Zero Dawn. That's always the one thing that Sony had over Microsoft. No matter what happens and no matter what Microsoft does, Sony has always had the edge when it comes to exclusive games. And the good thing that Sony's always been able to interpret is good second party studios. From games like Persona, which technically I would consider as a third party timed exclusive because sometimes they do go over to like PC, Nintendo platforms, to all the way of games like the Yakuza games that's been coming to Xbox here lately. That is always one good thing that Sony has been able to do an eye with, is whether or not a game is worth backing. And it looks like Microsoft might have got their hands on one of Sony's second party studios, Kojima Productions. For those of you that's living under a rock, he helped make the Metal Gear Solid franchise what it is today. And he went out on his own and made his own studio called Kojima Productions. And the first game they ever made was a PlayStation exclusive called Death Stranding. And although the game reviewed relatively well, got like an 82 on Metacritic, I don't know if it sold very well, because usually Sony, when they sell a lot of copies of a certain game, they come out and they really announce a certain threshold, like, you know, God of War selling 2 million in 3 days or 3 million. I don't really remember the exact number for that, or Spider-Man. It didn't seem like they had that much to say about Death Stranding. So a lot of people just assumed that, you know, it probably sold okay, but it didn't give them an absurd amount of profit to really reinvest back into Kojima Productions. So the question a lot of people had is Kojima going to re-up their contract or whatever form of relationship they have with Sony? And it looked like that maybe not be the case, because there was a lot of rumors a few months back that he was actually working with Stadia before they shut the door on that, and he had an exclusive game coming out on that platform. But obviously Google Stadia shut down a lot of production and types of first party games, so clearly that would be one of the first thing that is. It does look like maybe Microsoft has picked up where the slack left off for Google Stadia, and maybe this game will be exclusive. Now, there is a lot of things pointing towards this. I want you guys to remember a couple weeks ago to maybe like a month ago, Phil Spencer did an interview, and in the back, he had a lot of stuff on his shelf that, you know, these days it's kind of like Where's Waldo with Phil Spencer's shelf, that he likes to put stuff up there that represents stuff he's doing. And there was a reference on there to Death Stranding, so people automatically assumed maybe Death Stranding is coming to Game Pass. Let's fast forward to today. Now, a lot of talk has been going on with Kojima Productions here lately, and a particular title called Abandoned, and it was rumored to be exclusive for the PlayStation 5, but it looks like that may not be the case. So there is a lot of speculation going on there. It's purely rumors. Let's keep this right now until Microsoft or Kojima comes out openly and admits that this is going on. But there's a lot of insiders on the internet that is confirming that there is some form of communication going on here, especially individuals like Jeff Grubb. He rarely wanted people to know that, look, like, I do know that there are communications going on between these two individual companies, but we don't know if anything was actually set in stone. For all we know, they could have talked and then they could have decided that this is not a direction that either company wants to go, and they could have completely stopped negotiations. So right there, we know there's something with Kojima Productions and Xbox. Like, I don't know whether or not this is going to be comes a fruit. I don't know whether or not this is actually going to happen, but I do know that when Jeff Grubb talks, people tend to listen. He has a great track record in terms of things like this, and he usually gets a lot of things right. Now, let's talk about Kojima Productions in general. You guys know, if you've been watching me for a while, I'm not the biggest fan of Death Stranding, and a lot of my ideals when it comes to Kojima himself is I feel like he sometimes lets his imagination take hold, and sometimes he does stuff without really thinking if anyone wants to do that. For instance, I didn't think Death Stranding was the greatest game in terms of gameplay, because it looked like just pretty much a UPS simulator. But we cannot deny that Kojima has a cult following. And I mean cult following, I mean these people respect him and they respect what he's done, and they will go to any platform that Kojima chooses. And I think Microsoft needs that type of influence right now. Do I care whether or not Death Stranding comes to Game Pass or his new title comes to Xbox? No, I do not care whatsoever. I feel like Kojima can go anywhere else and it would not affect me one bit. One of the reasons it wouldn't affect me is because I have every platform. But I do feel like his type of influence in the Japanese market might help Microsoft hit that Asian market a little bit more than they currently have. Sure, they've been doing fantastic with getting stuff like Dragon Quest, Final Fantasy, you know, even the Tales games all coming to Game Pass the day it comes out, including stuff like Kingdom Hearts. But they need someone in their corner, and I feel like they don't really have that right now. And you know, they have studios that they work close with, but they need someone that they are backing 100%. And I feel like Kojima could be that person. He does have a lot of influence in the Japanese market, and that's something that Microsoft really needs. Now, it's like I said, I don't care if this happens, but I know a lot of people that do. I know there's a lot of huge fans of Kojima, and if they did this, obviously it would come to PC as well. So a lot of people could go to the PC route, but the people that don't go to the PC route, that's almost a guaranteed Xbox Series X purchase. And I think they should really capitalize and go this direction. Now, hopefully we'll find something about this out at E3 this year, which is in June. I think it's like the 12th through the 15th. And maybe we'll know a little bit more about if this is true, and if it is true, if it happened. Now, I do think that this is probably going to happen. I just don't know if it's going to be a full-blown exclusive or maybe a marketing push, or they're just publishing it in general. Now, most likely it's going to go off who is publishing the game. And in this article and what I've been seeing on the internet, it does look like Kojima is pushing for Xbox to publish this game. Now, I don't know if that's true or false, but if that is true and Microsoft is indeed publishing this game, I feel like it would give them a lot of room to negotiate this going to Game Pass and maybe even make it an exclusive. But that's just my opinion. Tell me what you guys think in the comment section below. Is Kojima's games even something the Xbox crowd's looking for? I do feel like more games coming to the platform is better than less games going to the platform. So even if it's not an exclusive, and even if it doesn't come to Game Pass, we need Kojima's games on the platform to make it a more diverse library. But that's just me. Like I said, put in the comment section below how you guys feel about Kojima. And until next time, this is Gaming Addict. I'm out of here. Peace.